Welcome back. It's that day of the week again when we explore and appreciate green ideas and inventions. This is Going Green. Now, the next time you want to cut down an old tree, I don't know why you'd want to do that, you might want to think again. Did you know that a 50-year-old tree has an estimated value of 9 million pesos? Plus, did you know that the Philippines is no longer composed of 7,107 islands? Today, we are 3 islands short. Oh no. These are only a few of the things young leaders learned over the weekend in the Ateneo National Environmental Conference, or ANECON. Now, we're giving you a backstage pass to this exclusive event, and joining us are Mr. Jed Lim, Kelvin Du, Bernadette, and Margarita Rojas. Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning, guys. This sounds like such an exciting project, you know. Tell us about it. Give us an overview. Who wants to start?
Yeah, I can start.
All right.
So with the Ateneo National Environmental Conference, it's actually a project under our student council in Ateneo.
Okay.
So one of the thrusts of our student council is externalization and policy engagement. Mm-hmm. So in line with this, our school, the School of Science and Engineering, had this conference last weekend.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so well, I'm gonna
like
briefly
tag team that's going on here. All right, take over, buddy. What's next?
Well, I'm gonna briefly discuss about this conference.
Yeah.
So basically, it's a 3-day event, and we envision to promote awareness on the various threats and the various threats posed by climate change.
Right.
And we want to be able to formulate solutions and be able to integrate these solutions into the roles of the Filipino youth.
Mm-hmm.
So I'd also like to discuss the goals of the conference,
yeah,
so that
absolutely.
You have a brief idea of
sure.
it. The first goal was to be able to establish a league of environmental youth leaders committed towards environmental sustainability.
All right.
And then we want to be able to build this network among our environmental advocates for our current and future participants.
Uh-huh.
And finally, we wanted to be able for our delegates to be able to formulate resolutions directly addressing the problem of climate change, which can be implemented in their own areas, wherever they're from, nationwide.
All right. Well, who was this geared towards in particular? I mean, who came to attend the conference?
Me. I was a delegate for my network, Philippine Youth Environmental Network.
Mm-hmm.
IFED, and it's under CN actually, Southeast Asia Youth Environmental Network. And I was also together with my co-members, yeah, co-members in my organization.
All right, but yeah, I mean, who else ran this? I mean, you guys are, you're so young. How did you organize something like this? You know.
Well. I am the facilitator, and I came along with other facilitators in different NGOs such as Resikolong, Pusong Resikolo, YSI, and a lot of other NGOs. So it was a partnership, really, of different and environmental NGOs. So it wasn't just really Sanggu, but it was a help of a network of organizations, of environmental organizations.
Okay, and now I hear that this was a very successful event, activity for you guys. I mean, what did you guys come away with? What were the learnings over the weekend?
As a delegate, probably what struck me the most is also my co-delegates was what Mr. Ginto said during the last day of our conference. He said, bloom in your own field. Mm-hmm. And it's very apt for us because we came from different fields. I was an environmental science student. And then my co-delegates were biology students. Some were actually in mechanical engineering.
Right.
And Mr. Ginto pointed to us that you don't have to be an environmental scientist in order to help mitigate and adapt to climate change.
Mm-hmm.
As a facilitator, I was really surprised how the students increased the knowledge during the conference.
Mm-hmm.
As a facilitator also, I saw that they were really empowered by the talk of Ms. Gina Lopez regarding the Mining Act. She really evoked their emotions. In the conference, we teach them the knowledge regarding climate change,
right.
But it was Ms. Gina Lopez who was able to really touch their hearts.
Uh-huh. Now, yeah, you guys wanted to touch on that, on the issue of mining in Palawan in particular. I mean, that's a very, it's very much in the news now. You guys wanted to touch on that, to talk about that.
Actually, Ms. Gina's talk was one of the highlights of the conference. So during her talk, almost all delegates, if not all really, the delegates were really inspired to join her in the petition campaign.
Mm-hmm.
So what she talked about was mainly about the current situation of the mining operation in Palawan, as well as the unfortunate death of Dr. Ortega just last week. So from her talk, the delegates actually said yes to her offer of helping out in the petition, the no to mining in Palawan petition. And after that, after the conference, even now we have connections with our delegates, and all of us are actually doing our part in promoting the petition. So we do it through online, such as social networks, especially on Facebook. And we also do email blasts and stuff.
It's really a joint effort among all of our our organizers and participants.
All right, you know, the Palawan mining issue is something that's, you know, obviously at the forefront of the some of the things you want to address. But what are some of the very concrete moves that you guys, you know, as a group of people have come together? What have you guys decided to act on in unison? What are some of the concrete plans and concrete issues that you want to address?
So after this 3-day event, on the final day, we were able to come up with resolutions. The groups were able to formulate each resolution. So we were able to come up with 8 resolutions. Some of these are the adoption of the solid waste management program, currently also being used by the Ateneo itself. Others are conducting general waste reduction programs, the usage of a rainwater facility as an alternative source of water, as well as programs to promote environmental sustainability. Oh, and one more thing. There's a resolution stating that they'll be creating a project entitled the Philippine Youth Environmental Week. I think that's very interesting. Gonna happen sometime
November. During the environmental month.
Basically, they will be doing simultaneous acts of environmental movements all over the Philippines, from Mindanao to Luzon to Visayas.
All right, very cool that you guys have organized this. Now, we opened, you know, we opened the segment with a little bit of trivia about, you know, a tree, a 50-year-old tree being worth so and so many million pesos. Or there's some other little-known facts, such as according to Conservation International, there are 128 key biodiversity areas in the Philippines, which is one of the countries in the world with the most KBAs. I mean, this is really some of the stuff that we don't, you know, little factoids that we don't know. But explain some of those little facts, some of those little trivias. Like the tree fact is interesting. What do you mean by that? 9 million pesos for a 50-year-old tree?
Well, the equivalent of trees can range in a lot of things. For instance, a tree can be transformed into papers, a tree can be used as to build houses, etc. And that's where they get their figures.
Okay. So what about the fact that, you know, we are so many of the places in the Philippines are a biodiversity hotspot? You know, what are some of the things that we can be doing to make sure that it stays that way?
Yeah, actually, preservation is one of the things that we discussed in the conference, especially in Palawan, since we actually, after Ms. Gina Lopez's talk, we actually related the different issues to Palawan, especially on biodiversity. So, when she talked, she told us that there are actually around 17 key biodiversity areas in Palawan, and these are threatened by the mining done in Palawan. But what we can do is actually what we want to do is to really stop the mining in Palawan, and then we can focus more on tourism and agriculture to help the Palawan's economy.
Cool. I think you guys have started something great here. I salute your efforts and wish you the best. And obviously, this is something that you want to do year after year.
Yes.
What are the future plans? How can people get involved? How can people attend the next ANICON? You know, what are the plans? How can people get involved?
Well, we do have a website. It's currently named as anicon2010.com, but we'll probably update the website and then post information about the future conferences like this to happen. Just be posted on the website. I think that's the best way.
Very cool, very cool. Well, like I said, I really admire the work that you guys have started here and wish you all the best. Good job. Congratulations, guys.
Thank you.
All right. Thank you very much to Jed, Kelvin. Let me see if I got this right. Margarita and Bernadette. Yes. It's confusing sometimes. You guys look so much alike. Did anybody tell you that? All right. Thanks so much, guys, for being here. Do you have the next great green idea, folks? Or do you have any out-of-this-world plan to save the planet? Well, let us know and tell us what you're doing to help save the environment. Send in your pictures and thoughts to ancgoinggreen@gmail.com and get a chance to be featured right here where we are going green.